This is a line graph. We typically use a line graph to display how a quantity changes over time. Well, now here, we're displaying how two different quantities change over time. It's kind of two line graphs in one. You're smart enough to think about two things at once. Now let's see what we're displaying here. First, the yellow line is the number of tons of cereal harvested in the entire world. And then the white line, that's the number of hectares of land harvested, again, in the entire world. Hectare, that's about 2.5 acres. Now let's talk about how to read this graph. Say we're interested in the amount of cereal harvested and the amount of land harvested in 1980. Well, we find 1980 on this array of years here horizontally, and then we go up the 1980 line. Now where it hits our white line here, the line we have here for the land harvested, that tells us how much land is harvested. And we read that by coming back over here to look at the amounts that are over here on the vertical scale. So the amount of land harvested is somewhere between 0.5 billion and 1 billion hectares. And this looks like it's a little closer to the 0.5 billion. So this is probably, you know, 0.7, 0.71, 0.72, something like that. This is around somewhere around 0.7 billion hectares of land harvested. Now, to figure out the amount of cereal harvested, we keep on going up here to the yellow line. We get to this point right here, and we see that that's a little bit higher than 1.5 billion. So maybe it's, you know, 1.52 billion or something like that, tons of cereal harvested. Now, I didn't just make all these numbers up. I actually went on to the UN website, downloaded all these data, and built this graph for us. I was inspired to do that by the book Rational Optimist by Matt Ridley. He told an awesome story with this picture. We'll get back to that story in a minute. But first, we're going to answer a few more questions about this line graph so we can make sure we understand how to read it. First question is, which has grown more over this time frame, the amount of cereal harvested or the amount of land harvested? Well, if we look at the amount of land harvested, well, this line stays pretty flat. At the end, it's, you know, a little bit more than 0.5 billion. At the end, yeah, it's a little bit more than 0.5 billion. Hasn't grown a whole lot. Now let's check out what happens here with the cereal harvested. In the beginning here, it's a little less than 1 billion. At the end, it's all the way up here at 2.5 billion. The amount of cereal harvested has grown enormously. So the amount of cereal harvested has grown much more than the amount of land harvested. Next question. In what year did we clear 2 billion tons of cereal harvested for the first time? We look here at our 2 billion tons line, and we're looking for the first time the amount of cereal harvested goes above that line. The first time is right here. And we figure that year out by going down to the year scale, and we see that it's one after 1995, which is 1996. That's after I graduated from college, and probably before you were born. Ah, that hurts. Next question. Which years had the biggest increases in the amount of cereal harvested? Well, now we're looking for the years in which this graph, the yellow graph, that's the cereal harvested, jumped the most. So we can see a few of those. We can see one here, got another jump here, big jump here, really big one up there, there are a couple in a row here. So we can see that in this year, we had some amount this year, and then we had a big jump to the next year. So this year, we had a lot of growth in the amount of cereal harvested. It's one year before 1985. That one's 1984. We can do the same thing for each of these others, figure out what those years are. This is 1989. This is 1996. That was our first year that we went over 2 billion. And then here we have 2004. 2007, and 2008. 2004, 7, and 8. So we got that covered. Let's move on to this. Have we ever had the amount of cereal harvested increase by 500 million tons? 500 million, that's half a billion. That's 0.5 billion. And we see on this scale at 0.5 billion, well, that's about this much. It's the distance between these two horizontal lines, difference between 0.5 billion and 1 billion. So has this cereal harvested line ever jumped by this much in a single year? Well, we can see that that's never happened. It's never even come close to jumping by a whole 0.5 billion in a single year. So the answer to that question is no. We've gotten better, but we haven't gotten that much better that fast. All right, so we come back to our story. What is the story that this line graph is telling us? Well, we saw that kind of right at the beginning. We talked about how the land harvested stays pretty much the same this entire time. While the land harvested staying the same, the amount of cereals harvested is going up and up and up. From the beginning of the graph here to the end, it's going up by, it's almost two and a half, it's more than two and a half times higher at the end than it was at the beginning. We're producing more food with the same amount of land. We can feed more people with the same amount of land. What this is a story of, what this is telling me, is that wicked smart people are using math and science to make the world a better place.